The quotient rule, level 1. In the previous videos, we dealt with functions that were formed by a product of two or more functions. Recall that the way we dealt with those types of functions was to apply the product rule. In this video, we will learn how to deal with functions formed by a quotient of functions. The quotient of two differentiable functions, f and g, is itself differentiable at all values of x for which g of x does not equal 0, because division by 0 is undefined. One way in which we can obtain a formula for the derivative of a function formed by the quotient of two functions is by making use of the product rule. Say we have a function r of x that is formed by the quotient of f of x and g of x, making sure that g of x does not equal 0. If this is the case, then we can multiply both sides of this expression by the denominator g of x. Next, we take the derivative of both sides of the equation as follows. We will go over this technique of taking the derivative of both sides of the equation in greater detail in a much later video. This technique is known as implicit differentiation. We are essentially taking the derivative of both sides of the equation. Notice that the left-hand side of the equation is formed by a product of two functions, so we need to apply the product rule. Applying the product rule, we obtain the following expression. Next, we take the derivative of the right-hand side of the equation. In this case, the derivative of f of x is going to be equal to f prime of x. Having taken the derivative of both sides, we now need to solve for r prime of x. So we subtract the product of r of x and g prime of x from both sides. And then we divide by g of x on both sides of the equation. We are almost done. Next, we need to replace r of x with an expression in terms of f of x and g of x. Recall that r of x was equal to the quotient of these two functions, so we go ahead and substitute this expression. Then, it is just a matter of cleaning up this expression and rewrite it as a single fraction. We accomplish this by adding the terms in the numerator by finding a common denominator, as follows. Then, we simplify the complex fraction, resulting in the following expression for the derivative of r of x. This formula is known as the quotient rule. Using prime notation, we can write the quotient rule as follows. The quotient rule says that the derivative of a quotient is a denominator times the derivative of the numerator minus the numerator times the derivative of the denominator, all divided by the square of the denominator. The quotient rule and the other differentiation rules learned so far enable us to compute the derivative of most rational functions. Now, unfortunately, you do have to memorize this rule. Keep in mind that you can always derive it by using the technique of implicit differentiation. Another way of remembering this rule is by using the following mnemonic device. Let the function on the numerator be the high function, or top function, and let g of x be the low function, or bottom function. We can now remember the quotient rule as low d high minus high d low all over the square of what's below. Once again, low d high minus high d low all over the square of what's below. Here, the letter d represents the derivative. Alright, let's practice this new rule by going over a couple of examples. Find the derivative of r of x equals e to the x over the square root of x. I hope you recognize this function. We found the derivative of this function during the first product rule video. It turns out that we can also find the derivative by using the quotient rule. Similar to the product rule, we need to first identify f of x. This is going to be the function located on the numerator, or the high function, which ends up being the natural exponential function. In the same manner, the function in the denominator, or low function, will be your g of x. In this case, it will be represented by the radical function. Once you identified your f of x and g of x, it is just a matter of finding each function's derivative and substituting these expressions into the quotient rule formula. In this case, r prime of x is going to be equal to x raised to the power of 1/2 times the derivative of e to the x minus e to the x times the derivative of x to the power of 1/2 all over x to the power of 1/2 raised to the power of 2. Remember to rewrite radical expressions into fractional powers. This way, you have an expression that is in a derivative-friendly form. Next, we go ahead and find the derivative of e to the x and x to the 1/2. We also simplify the denominator. Doing that, we obtain the following. For the most part, the last step usually requires you to clean up the expression by collecting like terms and/or reducing complex fractions. This would be the case for most quotient rule problems. With that in mind, we can rewrite this expression by dividing both terms in the numerator by the denominator. Doing that, we obtain the following. We can also rewrite the fractional powers back into radical expressions, resulting in the final expression equal to e to the x over the square root of x minus e to the x over 2 times the square root of x cubed. This is the same answer that we obtained in the product rule video. Note that it might be easier to use the product rule instead of the quotient rule. Make sure you keep on the lookout for functions formed by a quotient. It might be easier to find the derivative by rewriting the function and applying the product rule instead. Alright, let's try the next example. Find the derivative of r of x equals 2x over the quantity 4 plus x squared. Similar to the previous example, let's first identify our f of x and g of x. In this example, our f of x, or high function, is 2x, and our g of x, or low function, is the quantity 4 plus x squared. Let's go ahead and substitute these functions and their respective derivatives into the quotient rule formula. Here, I have the quotient rule written in prime notation. Substituting the functions, we obtain the following. Taking the derivative of f of x and g of x yields the following expressions. Now it is just a matter of cleaning up the expression by collecting like terms and simplifying whenever possible. Simplifying the numerator, we obtain the following. Then we go ahead and collect like terms, resulting in the final expression equal to the quantity 8 minus 2x squared over the quantity 4 plus x squared raised to the power of 2. Notice that there is really no need to expand the denominator. It is perfectly okay to leave your answer in this form. We can also factor out the constant 2 from both terms in the numerator. Notice that we can also factor out a negative sign. All of these forms are acceptable answers for the derivative. Alright, let's try a slightly more complicated example. Find the derivative of r of x equals the quantity x cubed plus x over the quantity x to the power of 4 minus 2. Alright, we once again have a quotient of two functions. Similar to the previous examples, let's go ahead and use the quotient rule. Our f of x, or high function, will be the quantity x cubed plus x, and our g of x, or low function, will be the quantity x raised to the power of 4 minus 2. Having identified our functions, we go ahead and substitute them into the quotient rule formula. Doing that, we obtain the following. Next, we go ahead and find the derivative of f of x and g of x. At this point, it is just a matter of collecting like terms and simplifying the expression in the numerator. We first need to distribute or FOIL out the expressions in the numerator. After that, we make sure we distribute the negative sign on the second polynomial. From here, we go ahead and collect like terms. Doing that, we obtain the following expression. Notice that there is really no need to expand the denominator. It is best to just leave this expression as it is. We can also factor out a negative sign in the numerator to make all the terms positive. In the end, the final derivative is equal to negative times the quantity x to the power of 6 plus 3x to the power of 4 plus 6x squared plus 2 over the quantity x to the power of 4 minus 2 raised to the power of 2. Alright, and this is the quotient rule in a nutshell. In our next video, we will go over slightly more challenging examples.